Today, we'll be discussing a new artificial intelligence language model and how it may link to consciousness, so stay tuned. In the last few months, the AI industry has garnered media attention over the bold statements made by Blake Lemoine, the Google engineer who tested an artificial intelligence chatbot built by the company. The engineer claimed LaMDA, the name of said chatbot AI, is sentient, in other words, has consciousness. Yes, you heard right, consciousness. The terms consciousness, sentience or self-awareness mean slightly different things depending on your reference, however, most non-scientific sources tend to adopt the same meaning for all three terms. For simplicity in this video, we will sometimes use either, or a combination of the terms, so don't be puzzled by it. Unless you've been living under a rock, I'm sure you've watched one of the many sci-fi movies that depict machines as having some form of sentience or consciousness. Movies like Ex Machina and shows such as Westworld do a good job at highlighting very interesting intersections of AI and consciousness. The statements made by Lemoine have further highlighted the long ongoing discussions about AI and consciousness. Can an AI system really be sentient? If so, how do we prove sentience or consciousness? If LaMDA is not sentient, then how many iterations does it need until it finally has a sense of self and awareness? It should be noted that most explanations of sentience define it as a base form of consciousness. Consciousness, on the other hand, requires other attributes like subjective experiences and awareness. It is mostly used as an umbrella term. Before we delve any deeper into this already confusing topic, let's explore the details we currently know about the LaMDA AI model. LaMDA is very powerful with over 137 billion parameters it can learn from. These parameters are abstract mathematical calculations but may be thought of as concepts like nouns, verbs, parts of speech, relatedness and other different types of features the machine is able to identify on an abstract level. The algorithms used in AI systems are algebraic calculations and calculus. These are the courses you half-heartedly enrolled in your freshman year, only to have it running your Tesla autopilot and Netflix recommendations. These AI algorithms are the power behind all AI tools. The LaMDA model is trained on dialogue data in order to understand a lot of the nuances in conversation. It is also trained on trillions of words and is an iteration on its predecessor, Mina. As you can tell, this model is huge and knows more words than your arrogant high school English teacher who wouldn't even give Shakespeare an A+. So now the question that we are met with as scientists, philosophers, lawmakers and society as a whole is, when do we know if a machine is sentient? Could a machine even be sentient and how do we go about finding this out? This leads us to the next part of this video. Consciousness, for the better part of a millennia, has been explored by the greatest philosophers and scientists alike. The verdict still remains: we're all clueless about its origins. Consciousness is the most personal thing we have, it's who we are. It's a sum of all our experiences, thoughts, awareness, learning aptitude, creativity and so many other concepts that are complex to define. This idea of self that no one can really understand but us. The subjective aspect of perceptions like taste and sight, known as qualia, is deemed to be the hard problem of consciousness. The concepts are so mind-twisting that even Shakespeare wouldn't have words for it. With the current challenge of even explaining exactly what consciousness is, it's hard for scientists to even begin thinking of how to measure it. AI is fairly new compared to other forms of science and is growing at a rapid rate. There are other complex questions surrounding this technology, including whether AI systems are truly intelligent or just regurgitating data back to us, or maybe a mix of both. Can we set strict objective parameters on AI models to also be in favor of humanity when they get to a point of truly transforming society? These questions and ideas will be explored in other videos in the near future, so if you want to see interesting discussions like this regarding everything AI and its intersection with other parts of our lives, please like this video and subscribe. It will keep us going. All in all, AI is directly linked to who we are as people. It's like the whole of humanity is looking down into a well and seeing our reflection in the water below. It tells us about different facets of humanity spanning philosophy, law and justice, ethics and so on. Maybe, at the point of singularity for AI, we would have finally reached utopia with all these aspects of humanity fully understood, but until then, we'll keep exploring, tweaking, learning, debating and improving. Finally, we attempt to answer the main question of this video. LaMDA most likely is not conscious or even sentient, but because there aren't any generally accepted standard definitions and tests for these concepts, it's hard to just refute the idea. Some philosophers believe consciousness can arise as a result of mathematical calculations, while others believe there is much more than just algorithmic coding. These chatbot systems are designed to ultimately reach human conversation levels so that it's practically indistinguishable from an actual person. There are other language models that are able to write entire movie scripts, like the GPT-3 model, which has even more parameters for training than LaMDA. Facebook also has the BlenderBot 2 AI chatbot that shows similarly impressive results. However, the fact that the AI does its job well does not necessarily mean it has attained sentience. Maybe this will get you questioning your own source of consciousness. Who knows? You could just be an improved Westworld robot, sent to play out a specific role and mingle with humans. Thanks for watching this video. I hope you learned a thing or two, or at least resonated with some things discussed here. What do you think about LaMDA's claim of sentience in LaMDA? Please leave your thoughts in the comments, I'd love to hear what you have to say. Until the next video, it's goodbye and thank you.